In this video, I show you how to create slideshows in Shotcut. Hi everyone, my name is Joe and welcome to Ubitronics. On this channel, I show you how to use open source software. Today, we're looking at slideshows in Shotcut. So the first thing I'm going to do is create a new project called Slideshow. You can obviously call yours what you want. And then I'm going to get my playlist item here. I did that by clicking playlist. I'm then going to navigate in a file explorer to where all of my images are. I'm going to select them all and put them into the playlist. Now you may have noticed that this car image is a very different shape and size to my other images. I've done that purposely so we can see some of the transitions and the different types and how we handle that within a slideshow in case you have different sized files. So let's come back into Shotcut. And the first thing we need to do is the playlist now contains all of our images. We need to order these images in the order that we want to see them, the way they will display when the video is created. So let's say I wanted chest to come first. I'll just click and drag, and elephant to come third, car to come second, bike to go to the fourth, all of them about as much as you want and in any order, but this has to be the order that you want them to display in when the video is created. Once you've done that, select the first one, hold shift on the keyboard, and then click onto the last one. This will select all of your items in the playlist. Now come down to these three lines down here on the playlist pane and then select add selected to slideshow. This is going to pop up a new little box, and by default the preview pane will start playing and the clip duration is 10 seconds. We can shorten or lengthen that if we wanted to. Let me put it down to about 6 seconds, and you've got the crop ratio, which this is how it handles images which are the wrong size. Right now it's on crop center, which means if I just zoom back a little bit there, when it goes to the new image, this picture here, it's cut off a lot of the actual image, so you may want that to be handled differently. You can select pad black. If I just go back to it, now you see the whole image but you've got black on the sides, or crop and pan. And as you can see, that crops to the full size of the image and then pans across the full image. Then we've got pad blur, which blurs the sides instead of having black. So you can choose what you want there. Whatever you do to this, it will affect all of your videos if they're all different sizes, etc. So once you're happy with that, you can go down to the zoom effect. As you can see, this zooms in very slowly on each of the images. That's this effect here. You can increase that or stop it completely. The transition is 2 seconds. That's the transition between the slides, so when it blurs or fades at the moment. And then this is how you change the type of transition. You could select any of these and you can play around with them as you like, or you can select random, which will just select random transitions between each one. I personally like dissolve, so I'm going to leave mine as dissolve, and then you can click OK, and what that's going to do is push all of that work into the timeline within a few seconds for you. So you haven't had to do each one manually, it's all just been done automatically in quick succession for you. Now you can preview it in the preview pane, so if you go back to the start and press play on the preview, you can now see the small fade in, or the zoom in, and then however we've managed the images that are the wrong size, and also the transitions, which for me I set as fade for each one at 2 seconds long. If for any reason you didn't like that, you can push Ctrl Z on the keyboard, make sure you've got your thing selected, and then go through the same process again, and you can keep on doing that until you've got the correct slideshow that you want to see. I'm going to imagine this is correct and this is the one that I want to have, but actually I want some audio in there as well. So if I right click track operations, add audio track, This gives me a new track just underneath here. And now I can go to my folder. I can add my sound in. I generally put everything in the playlist first so I can get back to it quite easily. And then I come down here and I can push it into the audio track by selecting and dragging. Now this is obviously way too long at the moment. So if you click onto the zoom tile here, that will mean that the longest part of your video is now on the screen. You can shorten that. And if I click that again, it will zoom straight back in. Now when I play the video, it will have the sound appended to it. Okay, so I'm not going to go through the whole thing there because you've already seen it a few times, but that's demonstrated how to create a slideshow in Shotcut. The final thing that you may need to do is to export the file. If you click onto export, click onto export file, then navigate to the place you want to save it, give it the name you want, make sure it's an MP4 file. That's general use. If you know you want it to be something else, then you can select it in the presets before you get to this stage. Otherwise, click save, and then you've got your jobs up here. When that gets to 100%, you'll be able to view your video in a standard video player. And I'm not focusing on the export settings here, but if you have any problems, then I do have another video on exporting files, and I'll link that in the description below for you. Once that's done, we can go back to our project and then play our new slideshow. Okay, so I hope that's been helpful. Please consider liking and subscribing, and I'll see you in the next video.